new Gallup poll finds only 31% of U.S. Catholics rate the honesty and ethical standards of clergy as very high or high. That number reflects an 18% drop from 2017 and follows a year of devastating revelations about Catholic clergy sex abuse. Joining me now is Father Thomas Petri, a professor of moral theology at the Dominican House of Studies. Welcome to the program.
It's always great to be here, Lauren.
It's great to have you. Let's be clear about these numbers. It's a Gallup poll. They took about 1,000 people, 18 and older, and they found of that group, only 22% were Catholic. So this poll is 22%, about, 210 people, and there's a plus and minus error of 8%.
No, I think it's helpful to put that in context, but it's not surprising that the lay faithful have lost some confidence in the clergy, especially given the scandals over the last year.
I agree with you. You are not surprised by these numbers. What are you hearing? Is it changing the way you minister now?
Well, I have to say personally, I interact mostly with Catholics who are going to Mass every week, and these are self-identified Catholics that Gallup polled, and so that includes those who don't go to Mass anymore. Those who the lay faithful I interact with are very nurturing and welcoming and continue to trust the priest that minister to them.
Does this type of information, though, change how you minister at all? I mean, I know that even if they are really faithful, that they must want to hear about your perspective on this.
Oh, absolutely. It does change how priests interact with the faithful, in as much as it's weighing on our hearts, just as much as it's weighing on the faithful's hearts. How we manifest our witness, that we're living lives in accord with our promises and our vows as priests. It's a challenge for all of us, and it reminds us to commit to that.
The poll found, let's put up some numbers here, that a majority of Catholics, 52%, say that religion is an important part of their lives. So that's about 100 people in that poll. And that number matches the average for the past 17 years. We did an exclusive poll of 1,000 Catholics, church-going Catholics, just straight Catholics, and they said 88%. That was 88% thought religion was important.
And once again, it's not surprising because you would have polled those who are actually going to Mass on a weekly basis, for whom the Mass and the liturgy is the lifeblood of their faith.
Do you think, though, that these numbers that Gallup had translate into church attendance?
Oh, absolutely. And of course, we've been seeing over the last 40 years that there's been a decrease in church and Mass attendance. I think there are things priests can do to work on that. I think celebrating the liturgy well, preaching homilies that are not vapid or trite, but actually elevate the mind and challenge people to live faithfully to God. I think all of these things would help bring people back to the pews.
Do you mention the sex abuse crisis when you preach?
Not explicitly. I often think that's very delicate because often there are children in the pews, and I think you need to be really careful when you're talking about matters of sexuality from the pulpit. So I always want to be delicate in addressing some of that. But I know that there's ways to do that, and I have done it delicately and thanking the people for their trust and committing to doing better as a priest myself.
Let's move forward as our last question here. What do you hope comes out of the February summit that the Pope has put together for bishops around the world?
I don't really know what to expect. The Holy See seems to be lowering expectations for that summit, which I think we all have high expectations. It's going to be an interesting summit because there are bishops from all over the world, and different cultures are reacting to this situation very differently, and they're not as passionate everywhere as we are here in the United States about it.
And nor have they had as public
exactly.
crisis. Thank you so much, Father Thomas Petri, professor of moral theology at the Dominican House of Studies.